Hello. Before I get into today's video, I wanted to discuss a few things about it. In this video, I use the term slave-making ant, which is an older term that still seems to be quite commonly used for the phenomena of one ant stealing the brood of another, which are then made to work for that ant's colony. The more scientific term for this is dulosis, which means slave-making, but in Greek. I think this term is better for several reasons, and going forward, I think it's the one that we should be using. So I wanted to make sure you were at least exposed to the term dulosis, because I hadn't heard it until after finishing this video. With that discussion of terminology out of the way, let us watch the rest of this video. In the mountains of western North America, many similar red Formica ant species coexist. Many of them build nests quite distinct from other ants, thatch mounds constructed from plant material they collect from the forest floor. This special structure is thought to absorb heat better as well as create warmth through decomposition, giving the ants warmer conditions in the cooler weather of subalpine forests. The thatch itself has chambers inside, and the nest extends into a subterranean network beneath the soil. These mounds are scattered throughout these mountain forests, sometimes built into fallen trees, sometimes wedged in between rocks. Formica ants have fairly complex societies, including tending to herds of aphids feeding on herbaceous plants, drinking extra sugar that these aphids excrete, and protecting them from predators. The problem, though, is with so many colonies of different species in the vicinity, they are in constant competition for resources, and to get an edge, each has their own rather devious tactic to beat out the others. This ant is living a lie. She is not toiling away to increase the reproductive output of her mother. Her work is aiding these ants' queen. These are Formica aeserva, a slave-making ant species that raid the nests of other ants and steal the brood, then raise them as their own. These kidnapped ants are completely unaware that they are slaves to the aeserva, not contributing to the success of their own kin, but a completely different species. There is another form of ant slavery in these forests, temporary nest parasitism. Queens of species that do this behavior are often small with strong exoskeletons. This morphology is perfect for letting them infiltrate the nests of a different species. The parasite sneaks around, searching for the queen. When she finds the queen of the colony, she wrestles the larger insect, eventually killing her. The parasite then begins to lay her own eggs. Like the standard slave-making ant, the workers are none the wiser to the sinister intentions of their new queen. Over time, the parasitic species begins to become more and more numerous, eventually replacing the old colony from the inside. By the time the last of the old species workers die off, the parasitic queen has used them to build a formidable colony ready to compete and produce reproductives. These social parasites often follow what is known as Emery's rule, which means that social parasites are generally closely related to their host. Sister species follow this rule strictly, while if they're just closely related, like being in the same genus, then they follow this rule loosely. Formica, though, are not the only ants out here who take advantage of other ants to get a leg up on the competition. And these mighty thatched nest mounds themselves have been invaded by other ants. Inquilines. An inquiline is a permanent parasite inside a colony of a different ant species, basically squatters that often make their home in some small corner of the nest out of the way. Some inquiline ants are unique in that they are workerless and basically just mooch off the host ants and make nothing but more reproductives, while others do produce a few workers that can gather food. Thank you for checking this video out. I really appreciate it. On this channel, my goal is to create quality short documentaries that educate viewers on the natural world, with the hope that they will inspire outdoor exploration and conservation action.